I'm Goleen Samari, and I'm faculty in the Department of Population and Public Health Sciences at the Keck School of Medicine. My research focuses on structural inequities and reproductive and population health. And what I mean by that is sort of systems of structural oppression related to race, gender, and migration, and how it relates to reproductive health outcomes or population health outcomes. And to give a little bit of specific context, so for example, in the migration space, I look at people who are forcibly displaced by conflict, or things like immigration policy in the United States and its implications for immigrants' health and well-being. In the gender space, I look at things like women's empowerment and household power dynamics and how community norms give women power and gender equity or take that away, and what are those implications for things like family planning, fertility, and reproductive health. In the race and racialization space, I consider things really that are looking at racialization of religious minorities, so how things like anti-Muslim racism and Islamophobia have implications for population health, relatedly anti-Semitism and its implications for population health, and really thinking about racism in its structural form as a driver of health inequities. Another piece of my work is that I tend to focus both globally and domestically. So domestically, I focus on immigrant communities, primarily those from the Middle East and North Africa regions of the world. And I also globally focus on that region as well, in engagement with those communities and public health programs and efforts in those countries. My interest in this research was really driven by my personal and family identity. When I was coming up as a public health student, I was really struck by the fact that the communities that I came from and that I was interested in were really absent from public health research spaces, and I wanted to elevate their needs, their public health sort of interests and needs and community needs to the forefront. And so I focused in my master's program, I have both a master's of public health and a master's of arts in Islamic studies. And that was really important to me because I knew I wanted to really look at Muslim communities and communities from the Middle East and North Africa. I also focus on immigrant communities because I am first generation, a child of immigrants. I really grew up in an immigrant community, and so it was really important to me that the public health needs of these communities were elevated and in the forefront of people's minds when they were talking about public health policy or allocation of resources or how to make sure there's truly health equity at a population level. I see the implications of my work everywhere. I try to make sure to see it everywhere, particularly in policy spaces. In, for example, the last 10 years when we've seen a rise in anti-Muslim racism, my work has been used to advocate for things like national commissions to combat Islamophobia. As we've seen a rise in anti-choice policies and the fall of Roe, my work has helped contribute to amicus briefs and other advocacy related to abortion rights and access. I see my work in global spaces, in discussions about how to make sure public health programming is adequately reaching refugee and forcibly displaced populations. And so the real world implications for me are the most important part of my work, because otherwise, why are we sitting in offices like this doing this research? And so it's really important to have a programmatic tie to what I do, whether I'm informing public health programs or other types of resourcing and programs, and a policy tie to what I do. So whenever I publish something based on my research, I also try to make sure that there's a policy tie-in, a policy brief, a public dissemination of that work, so I can have a real impact on solutions for the communities that I care about the most.